Hello, my name is Trevor. I'm a developer and I'm a trainer here at Evolving Web in Montreal. And you might have noticed over the last couple of months that people are doing a lot more live streaming on Instagram and YouTube and Facebook. And last week we were doing an online training and somebody asked, is there an easier way for us to add our live streams that have been recorded on Facebook into our Drupal site as media entities? So I'm going to show you how you can do this, how you can embed your Facebook videos inside of your Drupal site. I'm going to show you a couple different ways to do that. I'm going to start with the most obvious way to do that. And I have here a live stream that I've done before. If you have done a live stream or you have a video that you want to embed, doesn't have to be a live stream necessarily. After it's been recorded or uploaded, in the top right, you'll see right here these three dots, and you have an option, embed. And it'll show a little embed code here. So I'm going to take this code, I'm going to copy that, and I'm going to add a new piece of content, just a basic article, just to show you here. Add an article, and I'll say, basic embed a Facebook video. And I can change the text format to be full HTML, and I will go to the source, and I will paste that in there, and I will press save. Okay, and to give this a second, and it should appear. There it is right there, and it can play. Okay. You're familiar with him. All right, that's one way to do it. The downside of doing it this way is, usually you don't want to have your editors have full HTML access. So you might break some stuff in there. Also, it's just kind of it's kind of ugly. We should have a dedicated field for this. And the other thing is, if you're using the media module to organize your content, this isn't going to show up in there. So I'm going to show you what the media module does behind the scenes here. In Drupal now, it ships with it. So I've enabled the media module inside of here. And when I go to content, I have this new media tab right here. And I have some things that I've already previously done. I'm going to show you that in a second. So I have created two content types. I got one content type here called remote video and Facebook video. There's two ways we can use Facebook with the media module. So one module here is called Facebook O Embed. I'm going to show you this one first. It's a little bit of a recent module. There's not many people using it, but I'm going to show you it. And then afterwards, I'm going to show you another one called Media Entity Facebook, which does something similar, but there's more people using this, even though it hasn't had a release in quite a while. Just want to show you both. So I'm going to start with Facebook O Embed. I have downloaded and I've put this into my site. I'm going to enable it. So I'm going to go to extend and just enable Facebook O Embed support. And what this is going to do is right now inside of our site, I've enabled the media module and I've got a few media types here. We've got audio, document, image, video for a local video that we can upload. And then we have this one here called remote video, a remotely hosted video from YouTube or Vimeo. Now, YouTube and Vimeo, those are the only options we have out of the box for remote video. But you can see here those two options right there. I'm going to enable this module, Facebook O Embed support, and it's going to add another, give us support for Facebook video. So I'm going to hit install. Okay. Module Facebook O Embed support has been enabled. Go back to my media type here, the remote video. I'll hit refresh. And now we see Facebook there is now shows up as an option. I will click it and press save. Okay, so let's try this out. I'm going to go back to my content types, structure, content types, and I'm just going to use the sample content type I've made here called remote video. I'm going to go manage fields, and I'm going to add a media field to this, reference media. and I will call this remote video. Okay, just one value, of course, for this. And when you create a media field, it'll ask you what media type do you want to use. Of course, we're just going to choose remote video. So this will include the YouTube, the Vimeo, and now the Facebook embed. All right, let's press save. Now, one thing that people run into when they try this is, okay, let's go ahead and let's make a new piece of remote video content. So we'll add content, remote video. And you have to give a title, of course, we'll do that in a second. But then it just shows this autocomplete field here. And it says you have to create your media on the media add page before you can do it, add it. So we could do that. We could go like this and add the remote video. And so I'll try that here just as an example. So I'll take my video. All I have to do is copy the URL of my video here. I'll do that. I will add that. But that is a weird extra step to have to ask your people to go and add the media first and then go back to your content and add it there. You can save yourself a step. If you want people to be able to add it in line, you can do that here rather than having to make it and then go refer to it. I'm going to show you how to do this. We're going to use this module here. It is called Inline Entity Form, and it lets us create the media element, media entity, as you are making your content. So I've downloaded this module. I am going to enable it. Inline entity form provides a widget for inline management, creation, modification, removal of referenced entities. So I'll go and install this. All right, now what's changed? Well, now on my content type, structure, content types, remote video, I'm gonna go to the manage form display. And down at the bottom here, at my remote video, it is set to autocomplete. That's how it is by default. Well, I have this new option here called inline entity form, simple and complex. We're just going to choose the simple one right now. And we have some options that we can change, but we're just going to leave it as is right now. So we'll save that. I'm going to show you the difference. So go to content, add content. We're going to add a remote video. And now we have this right here. Instead of us having us to create the media first and then reference it, now we just have those fields in there. So I'm going to say tour of the moon. And I will paste my Facebook page in there. Press save. And of course, you can modify and rearrange these fields, but just for now, I'm just going to leave it as is. Press save. All right, tour of the moon. And there it is, right there. Okay, so that's one way that you can do that. Now again, that module right there, Facebook OEmbed, not many sites are using it. It's kind of a new module, so not many people are using it, but it has been updated in the last few months. So maybe you want to use that one. But there's another one here called Media Entity Facebook, which has been around for a few years now, almost 3 years, hasn't had a major release since then, but there are more sites using it. And so the issue queue, there are more people. It's more active there. So just giving you options, this is another module you might want to use. So I'm going to show you in a separate content type, I'm going to enable this module and show you how you can use that. It's a little bit different. All right, I'm going to go to extend, and I'm going to add a module, Media Entity Facebook. Okay, the difference here is in the last one, we had that remote video media type, and there we could just add Facebook as another provider. What this module does instead is it adds a whole different media type called Facebook Video. Okay, so we'll install this. I'll show you what I mean. All right, it's been enabled. When I go to Structure, and if I go to Media Types now, and it doesn't show up automatically, but if I go Add Media Type, in the Media Source, now we have an option here called Facebook. Okay, so I'm going to make a brand new media type, and depending on how your site is set up, maybe this is the better route for you. So go Facebook, Video, Embed. Embed's a video from Facebook. And choose the media source to be, of course, Facebook. All right. Now there's a lot of information that we could choose here, but I'm just going to leave that as is for now. Field mapping and all that. I'm just going to press save. And now we have a new media type here called Facebook Video Embed. So I am going to go to my content type that I've left blank for now. Structure, content types, Facebook Video. I'm going to manage the fields on this. And I'm going to add a new field here called, it's a media field, and I'll just call this Facebook Video Embed. Okay, just one item. And now you can see before we chose remote video, and that's where we had that other Facebook option enabled. But now we have this totally different media type, Facebook Video Embed. Enable that and press save. Okay, let's add a piece of content that has this new field with it. So go to content, add content, Facebook video. And now you can see we have that same sort of issue, if you will, where you'd have to add the piece of media first and then be able to reference it. You can do the same thing here on this content type. Go to structure, content types, and on the manage form display of this Facebook video content type, I will change that Facebook video embed field to use that inline entity form, simple. Save. Do this again. I'm going to add the piece of content, the Facebook video, a telescope tour of the moon. I can just leave the body field blank there. There are fields on this media type. You can obviously remove these and set them not as required, but I will fill that in there. Call this tour of the moon and paste in that URL. And of course, you could hide these options so they're filled in automatically, but those are just the defaults. Let's press save and see what happens. And by default with this module and this media type, it just shows us the URL for it. We can change this, of course. We can go to our structure, content types, Facebook video, and go to manage display on this content type, and it shows us the Facebook video embed field, and it shows the rendered entity. And you might think, oh, this is where I have to change it. Well, what you got to do instead, this is natural to think you might go here to change the display of it. It's rendering the entity of the media type itself, of the media entity. So actually, you have to go to structure, media types, Facebook video embed, and change the display here from, there's the Facebook field, the label of it is hidden, but the format of it is plain text. Change that to Facebook embed. Click save. And now, if we go back to our content and hit that Facebook video content type, the latest one that I just made, telescope tour of the moon. And there it is, right there. So those are a few different ways you could do it. Of course, you could use these in paragraphs. So you could do a fancy reordering of this, wherever you'd like to display it. Just a few different options for you. Hopefully one of those work for you. So at Evolving Web, of course, we teach a whole bunch of different things. This question came up in a recent training we did for a site building and architecture. So if you go to evolvingweb.ca/training, you can get a list of all the upcoming trainings that we do. We teach the basics for Drupal site building, making your own theme, module development, all sorts of that stuff. And of course, we're doing some other things too. Intro to HTML and CSS, PHP and JavaScript. So again, you can go to evolvingweb.ca/training to see a list of all our upcoming courses. And of course, you can sign up for our newsletter at evolvingweb.ca/newsletter to get alerted of all the different trainings we have upcoming. All right, thank you for watching. Hope that was useful to you. See you soon.